Hello everyone and welcome back to The Surprise. Now, if you watched my last video, I had mentioned something towards the end about how, well, actually at the beginning too, I had purchased a drill press and I came across this thing right here and it was extremely cheap. I think it came at like, I had gift cards, so it only cost me like $52 out of pocket to get this thing shipped and all. But that's with gift cards. I think buying it right off Lowe's.com, or I bought it on the Lowe's app rather, I think shipped to my house without gift cards, it would have been $108, which is still not a bad price. So I don't expect this thing to do a whole lot, but I kind of wanted to see what I could get for the price. And so far, I've only seen one other video out there that covers this thing. So I'm not going to try to top that video because that it does a great job. So if you, maybe if I think about it later, I will link it in the description below. But for right now, I'm going to go ahead and kind of go over the details a little bit, especially the stuff that you see on the box. And then after that, I will cut it, and then I will bring you guys back whenever I have brought everything out of the box. So let's go ahead and take a look at the box itself. So this is the Black Bull Drill Press 5-speed mini RPMs. Of course, like you said, 5-speed. So you got on the first and lowest, you got 620 RPMs. Then you go up one, that's 1100 RPMs. Go up another, that's 720 RPMs. And go up another, that's 2,340 RPMs. And then finally, at the highest setting, that is 3,100 RPMs. Cast iron table, talking about that right there. Cast iron table, steel base, and drill body. You use in workshop, garage, or basement. So that's basically what I'm doing. I'm in my workshop. Let's turn it around a little bit. Let's see here. 250 watts, 2.3 amps. I mean, made in China. I mean, I'm not really surprised. But there's your specifications if you want to stop and take a look at it real quick. And nothing else on this side. I had cut my address off because I knew I was going to be making a video for it. But anyway, so that's just the box. I've covered everything else that would need to be covered. Now I'm going to sit you guys down and I'm going to unbox everything and I'm going to bring you guys back when I've done that. Alright, third time's the charm because I've tried to film this part 3 times and I keep fucking up. So anyway, drill body. Belt housing, that's plastic. No big deal. This is where your switch is for your laser, and it's got this little plastic tab which you push down on. So that's gonna break sooner or later. No big deal, you know. $108, kind of expect it. Metal, plastic. All right, got it. There's your hardware for your drill press. You know, got your knobs. Got your rod for your table here. Got the little Allen keys, got some washers, and different stuff like that. Everything that I need to put this thing together should be in this bag. But anyway, iron feels pretty good. There's no catches. I don't feel nothing, kind of. I mean, that looks very suggestive, so just never mind that. What I'm trying to say was, this doesn't feel as rough as this. How to basic. Alright, now there's your cast iron table. One thing that everybody always says, even the manufacturers, they always put this kind of oil on your tables. What you want to make sure is to get that off there. So you might just want to, you know, grab a rag and scrub on it pretty good. Maybe grab some WD-40, get that off. I don't know, however you get grease off of shit. That's what you want to do. Anyway, here's the batteries for... Here's the batteries for the laser. So, I guess that pretty much covers it. I know I'm not doing a good job explaining everything, but... Yeah. Oh, wait, I'm missing one thing. I am missing... Almost forgot. Got your chuck here. Got your chuck. And your chuck key. Okay. Anyway, I'm going to cut it for now. I'm going to try to get this thing assembled, and then I will get back with you all on that one. And then after I get it assembled, I will kind of go over everything, maybe a little bit, and give you my final thoughts. Excuse me. But anyway, I'll get back with y'all here in a little bit. Alright, welcome back. I finally got the thing assembled. It wasn't that hard. I mean, if you kind of have common sense, you can kind of get this thing together. It's really no big deal. Now, I'm getting a lot of rattle right now, but I need to tighten this bad boy up. But see, I got the laser going on. That's gonna be forever. Like, I'm gonna have to just keep working on that, because, you know, you get this little Allen key here, and then you can actually adjust the lasers right here. You got one of these on both sides. So, you know, you can get it down to a T. I mean, you can square that puppy up like there ain't no tomorrow. But I cleaned this down. I got the grease off here, the oil. So this is extremely rough too, by the way. I don't know if you can see that. Like, it's pretty rough. A couple of little nicks. So, I mean, it's not perfect, but like I said, $108 out the door, straight to your house. One thing I also forgot to mention the last time I was filming was this, the chuck is actually a friction fit, so you put it directly on top of, what you have to do is you have to get like a piece of wood, or you can actually use like soft metal hammers or maybe a rubber mallet and tap that on. But what I did was I grabbed a little block of wood and I gave it some pressure to get it on there. It's just steel on steel. That's the whole thing that holds it together. So the chuck's not bad. I mean, it's not terrible. It's really, really not. Of course, you got your on and off switch. I'll go ahead and fire it up real quick and let you just kind of see. It's got a lot of rattle right now, but once I get it tightened down, it should be good to go. But runs pretty good. Then your on and off switch, you have this little key here. So when you take that out, that'll prevent it from being able to run. So I can do that, and it ain't gonna do nothing. So anytime you're gonna work on something like this, what you should do, I mean, anybody will tell you, especially if you work on loads of things. Well, number one, you know, this is my home shop, so I'm the only one that's ever in here. So I don't need to lock out, tag out. I know, you know, I'll just unplug it and I know I'm good. But if you're using this, you got other people around, if you're going to be doing some maintenance on here, if you're going to be changing the belt over, it's best to just pull the key out and then, you know, sit it to the side. So I'll put that back in there. Let me hop the top here. See, I'm kind of in the middle. I'm in the middle right now. I'm running, what's the middle there? I'm on number three. So number three, I'm running at 1720 RPMs. Is that right? Yeah, that's what it says. Now you got your list up here, and it shows you like where, you know, if you're on the lowest setting there, you're running at 620 RPMs. And then, you know, as the higher you go, the more RPMs you get. So, but, you know, being just testing it right now, I've just been running it on a lower RPM. See, I got a little give. You don't want it to be too tight, but that's what's causing all the rattling. So I need to tighten the motor up a little bit. I got it at a weird angle because my damn workbench is too big. So the instructions aren't very good at all. Just gives you like a parts list and that kind of stuff. So that was pretty useless. See here, you know, if you want to change your depth of your, like if you want to change the depth, you want more depth, right? Like right now, set at about, what is that? I'm having a hard time seeing. So, you know, adjusting these will definitely help you get, you know, either a larger depth or a not larger depth. So, I mean, there's really not much else that I can say. I'm just using a hyper tough drill bit because if I was going to fucking ream a drill bit out, I'd want it to be one of my cheapos. So, let's see. What else? Hell, I don't know. Got your chuck key here. I need to find a place for it so I don't fucking lose it, like all my 10 millimeter sockets. I mean, so far, I mean, I've already used it to kind of, I drilled one hole with it, and I gotta say, like, I knew this isn't gonna be like an industrial strength. It's not gonna be the best of the best. I mean, I think it's pretty good. I think you get what you pay for. I think it's perfectly capable of, you know, handling your everyday kind of at home hobby stuff. It's perfectly fine. It'll handle it just fine. Now, obviously, I can't really tell you that for sure because I haven't really used it all that much. But from what I can tell right now, I would say $108 out the door on your doorstep in a couple of days. I gotta say, I mean, it would be worth it to me. It's definitely worth it. Now, a lot of people like to get some of these old, or not old, but like they like to get cheap drill presses, and they would turn them into like makeshift milling machines, which it's definitely not the greatest idea, but if you're going to do that, you definitely want to buy a cheaper one. You don't want to spend hundreds and hundreds of dollars on a great drill press and then, you know, run it through the ringer doing stuff that it's not made to do. So, I mean, something like this would probably, if you're trying to, you know, cut corners and trying to make yourself a makeshift milling machine, I think it might be able to do it like a little bit. It's hard to tell. I mean, because, like I'm saying, like, these aren't really made to, it's a drill press. It's made to go up and down. It's not made to go side to side. So, I mean, you'll definitely wear it out if you do that. But, I mean, I feel like that's kind of a given. But so far, I'm impressed. I'm impressed with what I've gotten. It's not bad. But anyway, I know this isn't the greatest review. I'm freaking exhausted. But I wanted to kind of give you an idea as to what kind of drill press, mini drill press, that you would get for $108 with this brand. I mean, get you one. Can't go wrong. I mean, everybody, some of the reviews that I've seen, like on Amazon and on Lowe's, some people say that it's extremely underpowered for, for the advertised workload. I guess I'll find that out too later when I start actually using it. But I don't know. I'm a firm believer in, you know, getting what you pay for. So I'm not going to be too mad if the thing takes a little bit more time to drill a hole. Like, I'm never going to be in that big of a hurry to where, you know, like, I'm trying to rush. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed. I'm sorry it's not the best. If you want to see how this video, or not this video, but if you want to see how this thing is put together, I will try to link in the description the video that I had seen, and maybe that'll help you get this thing put together more than this will. I mean, this was just kind of an overview of the whole entire thing. I went over the RPMs, I went over the features, you know. Five-speed metal drill press with laser sintering device. I mean, I really need to work on that. Because I got this. This is straight. The base is straight. So I need to tweak that a little bit. But anyway, hope you guys enjoyed. Leave a like. Maybe comment. And let me know if you got one of these things. Hell, I don't know. I'm going to quit rambling. I got one more video coming up in the future. I think it'll be cool. It's not going to be quite like this, but maybe you'll enjoy it too. Peace out.